Hello from Tarakeshwar. Behind me is where the BJP candidate Swapan Das Gupta is currently temporarily staying. This is the BJP office in the constituency. The reason why we are in Tarakeshwar is because Tarakeshwar goes to polls in 2 days, and this is going to be an exciting election. Today is the day when Narendra Modi and Mamata Banerjee are both holding rallies nearby, and Swapan Das Gupta is also a candidate from BJP. From the TMC, we have Ramendu Singha Roy, who is also a block president of the party, who is also being fielded from Tarakeshwar. This is going to be an interesting election because he is also being said to be the chief ministerial candidate for Bengal. So we are going to follow him around. We have been promised an interview in the evening. Let's hope that happens. दादा बात करेंगे
मोदी जी खबर सुने मोदी जी कथा सुने हमें खूब भालो लागलो हाँ हमरा जानो मोदी जी पास ही থাকতে পারি
এখানে মোদি এসেছে তাই আমি প্রথম তৃণমূল করতুন বন্যায় গ্রামে বাড়ি আমার সেই জন্য আমাকে ঘর দেয় না কিছু দেয় না তৃণমূল আমি এনেছেন
করোনাকে টাইম পে एकदम भी माननीय जो कोरोना के पीड़ित जो थे उनको सेवा नहीं दिया हॉस्पिटल में उसका चिकित्सा नहीं हुआ
अच्छा पर आप बोल रहे कि कोरोना का ये तो आपने मास्क नहीं पहना है
जी मास्क तो पहने हुए हैं पर आप धूप जरूर देख रहे होंगे तो अभी बहुत जोर से प्यास भी लगी है थोड़ा पानी पिए थे और अभी ऐसे ही है तो अभी जब भीड़ में जाऊँगा तो फिर से पहन लूँगा ऐसा कोई बात नहीं है
चासी को इस बार चास करने के लिए एक एक बस्ता 50-50 केजी बस्ता बीज के लिए 5,000 रुपया खर्च करना पड़ा ममता दीदी नहीं बनाया आज जो किसी जो मोदी सरकार जो किसी बिल लेकर आए उसके विरोध कर रहे
हैं हमें एक टू मोदी संगे मोदी के देखते हैं हाँ देखते पे
स्वपन दास गुप्त हमारे गे प्रचारे আমাদের ওখানে সব কিছু করে দেবে বলেছে ঘর বাড়ি যাদের আছে ভাঙা পড়ি সব কিছু করে দেবে বলেছে এইটুকু আমি বক্তব্য রাখলাম জয় হিন্দ বন্দে মাতারাম
क्या बोला उन्होंने
उन्होंने बोला उन्नति करेगा हॉस्पिटल बनाएगा मेरा मंदिर जो है तारकेश्वर का वो उन्नति करेगा ये सब बात किया
सो द प्राइम मिनिस्टर हैज जस्ट अराइव्ड एंड बिहाइंड मी इज द हेलीकॉप्टर इन व्हिच ही अराइव्ड इन वी आर इन हरिपाल कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी एंड वी वर स्पीकिंग टू अ फ्यू पीपल they are all over the place like from Birbhum we met people from Shingur and we asked them what they like about the candidate so I think half of them knew who the candidate is some of them misspelled his name but a few of them also knew and they said that hopefully he will do better than the last candidate that they had so we also spoke to people about why what they think about Mamata Banerjee they refused to come on camera to say it they said that kuch nahi mila Nothing, they got nothing. Rupashri, Kanyashri, nothing. Some got Swasthya Sathi cards and when they went to the hospital to use it, they said ki vote ke baad aana, election ke baad aana. So people are clearly upset and they are attending a Modi rally. Okay, so correction. We just came here and we saw that he came in not one but 3 helicopters and there is a giant crowd here waiting to see the helicopters take off. I guess it's a very fascinating thing. We saw this in the Mithun rally also. A lot of people were just standing there to see the helicopter take off. I think it's a spectacle. It's a great spectacle. 3 helicopters just landed and now they will take off at some point with Modi ji in it. It's 4. We are here to interview Swapan Das Gupta. Now let's hope he shows up and actually gives us the interview. I have a feeling it might be a long wait to be honest. Because when we left, the rally was still on. So let's hope he comes back soon.
An hour later, Swapan Das arrived and we got the interview. Watch.
Welcome to News Laundry Interviews. I'm here with Swapan Das Gupta, who is the current candidate from Tarakeshwar. We just attended the Modi rally, as you saw, and he was there with Prime Minister Modi, and the rally was big. How much would you say the crowd size was?
Well, I can't estimate the crowd size because well, there were three hangars which were full. So I expect anything in the region of between, and there were lots of people on the periphery. So anything between, you know, 80 and 100,000.
There is a second wave of coronavirus going on. We were at the rally and we saw that there were very less precautions being taken when it comes to social distancing and people weren't wearing masks. Is it such a good idea to hold a rally right now?
I don't think this is a good, this is, you should ask the people in the villages. They don't really practice it. But it's obviously a great concern to you. So, you know, I suggest, you know, you should go and preach this very noble message of yours in the villages.
I mean, we saw people distributing.
You know, I'm going to talk about, I came here to talk about the elections. If you're interested in talking about the elections, talk about it. Otherwise, I'm sorry, you know. This is, at present, my mind is not.
Sure, fair, fair. Okay, so we spoke to the people there and clearly you have been going around Tarakeshwar a lot. They said that you visited their areas, etc. They highlighted a few issues as well that they had. So what are your main issues that you are basically highlighting during your campaign?
Well, there are two different. This is a constituency which is 90% rural. You may have just touched upon the 10% which is the town. Within the town, the biggest question is that of, you know, pathetic infrastructure which is there, whereby they have not been able to avail of the huge potential as a big pilgrimage center. And the facilities are woefully inadequate. And so there's a massive need for injection of funds for creating the basic structures whereby tourism can grow, and that will help local people find employment, it will help local businesses. The knock-on effects are huge. The issues in the villages are very, very different. The most important issue, to my mind, which is very important, is the issue of the conversion of mud houses to brick houses, which is as part of the PM's Awas Yojana scheme, which has not been delivered, and along with it is the drinking water issue for the village. That, to my mind, is the most important issue. Otherwise, you know, there are these issues of potato farmers, which is there, getting a remunerative price and being able to develop agro-industries which can sustain the potato.
Actually, we actually spoke to a farmer there as well, and she also highlighted that the mandis are not working well.
तो हमारे जो केंद्रीय सरकार मोदी का सरकार जो किसी बिल लेके आए हैं ममता बनर्जी उसके विरोध कर रहे हैं हम यही बोलना चाहते हैं कि हमारे यहाँ के इशू है जो ममता दीदी तो 10 साल हुए पश्चिम बंगाल में सरकार थी मगर उन्होंने एक भी किसी के लिए भाई के लिए एक भी स्टोर भी नहीं बनाया बीच पर्पस की जो आलू है हमारे हुगली है हुगली में आलू प्रधान है तो वहाँ के जो आलू के बीच है उसके लिए जो बीच आलू हम माट में खेती में नष्ट हो जाता है माने जल के माने पानी के दाम में हम बिकता है वो आलू के लिए कोई स्टोर तो नहीं बनाया चासी को इस बार चास करने के लिए एक एक बस्ता 50-50 केजी बस्ता बीज के लिए 5,000 रुपया खर्च करना पड़ा ममता दीदी नहीं बनाया आज जो किसी जो मोदी सरकार जो किसी बिल लेकर आए उसके विरोध कर रहे हैं
व्हाट हैव यू सीन अबाउट
देयर लॉट्स ऑफ द मंडीज इज यू सी दैट आल्सो देयर हैज बीन अ रिस्ट्रिक्टिव प्रैक्टिस बाय द एग्जिस्टिंग स्टेट गवर्नमेंट वेयर बाय फार्मर्स आर नॉट अलाउड टू सेल आउटसाइड सो दे नॉट बीइंग एबल टू गेट द मोस्ट रिम्यूनरेटिव प्राइसेस व्हिच पोटैटोस कैन फेच बिकॉज़ पोटैटोस इज समथिंग व्हिच हैज अ सॉर्ट ऑफ यूनिवर्सल इफ नॉट ऑल इंडिया डिमांड And they grow huge amounts of potatoes. I mean, this is completely a potato belt. So them being able to expand their markets, using the mandis as an instrument, as the platform, you know, it's not rocket science, but it's just basic facilities which haven't been given to them.
And other than that, what have you seen about the implementation of Mamata Banerjee schemes? Because a lot of people are complaining about corruption.
It's a very good question to ask. I'll give you a couple of these. You know, like old age pension, take for instance, you will find large numbers of people who have not got old age pension. if you go to the job cards, I mean, the Manrega issue about 100 days work, very hardly anybody gets 100 days work. These are the two big ones in the rural areas. And roads, which is the connective roads, which is from the PM, a lot of it comes from the state government, and a lot of it comes from the PM, Grameen, whatever it's called, Grameen Road Sangstha, whatever, you know, the PM road connectivity thing. A lot of places, they don't get roads because of political reasons. If someone is voted for the BJP or someone is sided with the CPM or something like that, the implementation of programs has been heavily dictated by politics and a very narrow form of partisan politics, which I think is very unfortunate because we are really talking about quite very, very poor people. And regardless of who they support and their democratic right to support who they want to, I think to be deprived of basic amenities because of that is criminal.
I'm being told that you're going...
Amphan, the other big issue there is Amphan. You know, Amphan, the devastation. You go there, find the people, nearly village after village will complain, we did not get a thing. While people who got compensation for Amphan are people who were two-story, three-story buildings and who are Trinamool leaders. So this naked form of corruption is something which is developing a huge revulsion in the villages.
So you're about to go to another campaign after this, I'm guessing.
That's a city campaign. That's in the city. Yeah. Because today is, you know, it's already, everybody's sort of a bit exhausted from everything. So,
I'm being told that Shuvendu Adhikari is going to be...
Yeah, he's coming at 6 o'clock.
So this corruption issue, actually, we went to Nandigram, we were covering Nandigram, and this was a big issue there. And when Shuvendu Adhikari was in TMC, there were allegations made that his men were the ones who were also doing what you just described. So how is it fair that he is now in BJP, and do you think that will end now?
It's not a question of how is it fair. Fact is, he is in BJP. He's fighting a political fight against Mamata Banerjee. We are not in the business of inheriting whatever the legacy of the TMC may have been, and it's not for me to pass judgment or it's on Shubhendu. You can ask him. What we are committed is to ensure an even-handed distribution of people's entitlements, and without, by taking away the political dimension from it. You can call that itself a political form, but that's another matter. I think that's a fairly more acceptable form of political. We want to universalize it as much as possible. And I think that plea is giving a good response in the countryside.
We were at the rally right now, and of course, Prime Minister was there. He came in 3 helicopters, and it was quite a spectacle because we saw like a large chunk of crowd coming out to see the helicopters.
It is a spectacle.
How fair is it for a Prime Minister to basically come with such a shosha and then basically...
It's part of the drill. I mean, either you change an entire SPG Act of what they consider as a threat perception. That's not for me to comment on whether three is good enough or two should be good enough. But yes, you're right, that is a spectacle. But, you know, a Prime Minister's rally is not something which happens every day. It's few and far between, and I don't want to necessarily suggest that the Prime Minister shouldn't be campaigning in election rallies.
No, I'm not saying he shouldn't. I'm saying that the taxpayers' money is being used to do this.
Everywhere, it is this protection of the PM is the taxpayers' money. Yeah.
So, are you in favour of sort of reworking that?
No, I cannot comment on security protocol. It's people's threat perceptions of how much. I mean, what can be said is that we shouldn't indulge in wasteful expenditure as much as possible. And within that parameter, whatever needs to be done has to be done. Without curtailing the PM's political right to be engaged.
No, no one is suggesting that he shouldn't campaign for rallies, obviously. We were also wondering that BJP has this strategy, especially in Bengal, that they have not declared a CM face yet. I was just trying to understand the strategy because you've already given an interview saying that the party will decide. So I'm not going to push you on that. But from the party's strategy level, do you think it's a better idea to have a prominent face when it's against someone like Mamata Banerjee? Or do you think it works otherwise?
Work both ways. I don't know. It'll actually be the results which will determine. We can be wiser in hindsight, or we can, you know, we'd say, well, it works here. So, but there are obvious, it's not always easy to decide on a face if you're not the incumbent. You know, and we were not the incumbent. So, under the circumstances, it's all right. Let's go. We've gone with multiple, I mean, people have their own list of, they've got their own checklist of who are the possible possibles and probables and all that. So let some speculation go. I don't think that's necessarily jeopardizing our campaign in any way. And nor, I mean, it was certainly a very, very important media question, but I've not really encountered it on the doorsteps. So, you know, there's sometimes a mismatch between what is the media interest, and a legitimate media interest, I may add, and between what the people consider as to be their most pressing thing.
So, if, say, for instance, you would be offered a job, would you be interested to...
It's not a question of who would be offered a job. The point is, at present, you're contesting for an MLA-ship. Now, MLA elections are difficult for the best of circumstances. They have a very different dynamics from a Lok Sabha election. Lok Sabha elections are far more sort of above the ground. And an MLA election is you have to really penetrate into the constituency, you have to meet much more personal engagement, etc. So it's a tougher fight in that sense. It's a different fight, but it's a tougher fight, I would say. So my focus at present is completely devoted to winning this seat for the BJP.
And you have also said that it's also very, as you said, it's different, but you also said that it's also very difficult because you have not any experience in electoral politics.
Yeah, I admit that. I've not had any. I've had experience in what might be called high politics, but I've not had any experiences in what might be called grassroots politics. So, I mean, I would be silly not to concede that is indeed a limitation which I have to face it, which probably makes me want to work doubly hard for it. It's a learning experience. It's the learning curve is very much there. So I hope I manage to imbibe whatever the experience has to offer me.
Do you have any insights to offer? Because I'm sure you have come from the Rajya Sabha and now you're campaigning on the ground. It's a very different sort of... Do you have any insights to offer for our audiences about how it's like to campaign?
Well, if you think it's easy, fighting elections a lark, it's not. It's bloody hard work. And especially in the summer, it's extremely grueling. But again, it's also a humbling experience because, you know, you're not the king. It's your fate is in someone else's hands, and you have. But it's important because you have to listen. You have to listen to people's grievances, even if I think a lot of people will tell you things. I don't think they necessarily expect you to resolve all their problems, but I think they do expect you to be sympathetic and have and view their concerns sympathetically. That's really what I think is there. The solution of problems sometimes is not in your hands as an MLA or something. It's policy matters and things like that. You know, I mean, I come across people who are terribly ill. You know, whose sons are ill. You know, someone I came across yesterday who's an 18-year-old boy whose mother came here weeping because both his kidneys are malfunctioning. Now, I tried to best to make her understand that it's not something within my capacity. I mean, but it's a very painful decision to try and explain that to someone. You know, you've got to find a donor, you've got to get, you know, matching. Then perhaps you can probably get a subsidy from a hospital. But all these processes have to be complete.
I see you're watching Republic Bangla. I couldn't help but notice.
Playing. it's not a premeditated decision. Yeah. I think anybody, whoever was here in this room earlier, was watching it.
But I wanted to ask you a question about regional media. Actually, we're News Laundry and we track the media as well. What is your sense of the regional media and its approach towards this election in general? Especially ABP and TT.
I have been glued into the Bangla television channels ever since for the past X number of months, but especially when the election season got going. You cannot ignore it. It's the one which sets the tone. But it's no better or no worse than what is called the national. It's a mirror image of that. The language is different, but it's basically a mirror image of that.
What do you mean by that, mirror image?
I mean, in the sense that it's the tone is set by someone, and these people are exactly, I don't know who sets the tone, whether the regional sets the tone or the national sets the tone. But anyway, they both mirror each other in that sense.
Would you say it's partisan, though?
Well, some of them are blatantly partisan, like most channels are. I have no illusions that some channel's objective. Absolutely no illusions. Neither do I have any illusions that the media is objective. The media is partisan. The question is how partisan? Mildly partisan or ferociously partisan? Or are they accurate? I mean, there's nothing wrong in being partisan. But the question is, are they partisan to the point of distortion, or are they partisan in their views? If they're partisan in their views, you know, that's perfectly kosher as far as I'm concerned.
That would apply for regional and national media, I'm guessing.
It applies to anything. It's general.
Can I ask you the coronavirus question again? Or
I've been lucky in not having the corona.
Have you been vaccinated?
I have been vaccinated once, and I hope it's by the time I finish this. I mean, I sometimes worry about it because this personally a question, because it is, and this ridiculous thing which people are now doing of shaking hands is really, which adds to the whole thing. But trust in God.
One interesting thing we saw at the rally as well was that people were distributing merchandise, BJP merchandise. Wouldn't it be actually better if you start distributing sanitizers and masks, maybe?
That's a suggestion for action. I'm sure we can take it up in a big way in the next meeting.
Thank you so much, Sapanda. Thank you.